gameplay. Today I am unboxing another Kiwico box. This one is a colorful chemistry. I have my auntie here with me. Say hi.
Hi.
Let's open this thing up. Whoa, that's all cool. Wait.
Ah! A little rainbow. Okay, let's go through our items and see what they're gonna give us. So it looks like we get a list of things that are in the crate.
So Vicky showed up, we have face that, we have that.
And so let's go through the scientific method. The scientific method helps you plan an experiment and learn from it. There are only 5 steps, but you can use them to figure out almost any problem. Do you know what the first step is?
Ask a question. Make a prediction. That's hard to say.
I know.
Test and observe.
With an experiment.
Draw a conclusion. Share your results. Then start again.
Last but not least, there's a secret 6th step to the scientific method. Do you know what it is?
Have fun!
All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna do is get our lab ready for experiments.
Yeah.
So we're gonna put this here. We're going to pour it into the beaker and do the same for the citric acid.
There's baking soda.
It's right here.
Can
so we're gonna, yeah. Citric acid is safe to handle but may sting if you have a cut, just like lemon juice does. Oh, if this happens, make sure to rinse your hands with water. Okay, we have our baking soda.
By the way.
And we have our citric acid.
Can I pour all of it?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Okay, now we're gonna use our stir stick to mix the powders together.
Ooh.
Get them nice and mixed. All right, now we're gonna take our powders and we're gonna pour them into the jar. So this is the red powder. Pour that little baby in.
Whoa.
Be precise.
Ah.
We'll do the yellow. Are you ready to get started with your experiment?
Yes.
Okay, so we're gonna use the large scoop to place 4 scoops of the beaker mixture into each jar. Make sure to knock all of the stuff off because we wanna be very precise. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice, okay. Now we're going to find the cap that is labeled red mixture and put it on the jar, and then we're gonna shake it. And we're gonna do that for all the other ones.
Ooh,
too.
Shake it, like shake. Whoa, look how cool it is.
Right, now we're gonna fill our spray bottle with water and screw the handle back on. And then we're gonna lock the handle.
And this?
Mm-hmm. I think we're gonna just put it on our tray.
Okay, guys, our lab's all set up. Now we can get started on our experiment.
All right, so our first experiment that we're gonna be doing is a color mixing experiment. We're gonna put our beaker over here. And we're gonna put this here. And then we're gonna put the tray, our plastic tray, on top of it. Place 3 scoops of blue mixture onto the tray. Spread it out to match the card. So we wanna like put it only in this little circle. Yeah, sure. We wanna do 3 scoops. So if you wanna just scoop it and then I'll spread it out, we can do it that way. Now we're gonna do the same thing to the yellow, making sure that you only do it inside of the yellow. Okay, that looks like enough. What do you think will happen when we add water to the colors?
It'll make a different color.
Okay, well let's find out if you're right. So we're gonna use our spray bottle and wet the mixture. And then we're gonna observe and see what color you create. Okay, let's keep going. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So cool. And we can use our stir stick to even make a little bit more green. How cool.
This is awesome. Look at this.
Okay, should we try and make a different color?
Yeah.
How about this one? Let's try red and yellow.
Oh, I don't know what that will make. Orange.
We're gonna find out. I think you're right. All right, let's mix it and see. So what's your prediction?
I think it'll turn orange.
Oh, it's mixing a little. Maybe we should use our stir stick and see. I feel like it is kind of making a little orange, but the yellow is a lot lighter than the red. Mmm, that looks like orange to me.
Yeah, it looks like a really light orange.
Mm-hmm. Now.
Let's switch out for blue and, oh, yes, purple. I want purple.
Okay, let's try it.
So fun, I love purple.
Ainsley, do you know what red, blue, and yellow are? What kind of colors they are?
What?
They're called primary colors, which means that they can be mixed together to make any color of the rainbow.
I think that's enough.
Okay.
I think a little red.
I feel like the red last time was so intense, so I wanted to just keep going. Ooh, I think I see a little bit of purple.
Me too. It kind of looks black on the camera.
Yeah, it kind of looks a little brownish, but. It looks purple.
It's like a dark purple.
Yeah, it's a dark purple. How cool. Okay, let's try our last one. What do you think?
Yes, this is probably the best one. We're gonna be combining all three of the primary colors. I can't wait.
We want to put it in the middle too. Okay, let's try our blue and put some in the middle. Really? What do you think it's gonna make?
Brown.
A little bit green too. Yeah, it looks like it's making some sort of brown or maybe gray.
Yeah, does that look kind of gray? Makes gray. Okay, we're done with this one. Let's go to the next project.
All right, so now that we know what kind of reaction happens when we mix colors together, let's make some colorful art. What do you say?
Yeah.
Let's do it. We're gonna take our tissue paper and we're gonna make sure that it's nice and smoothed out. And we're going to take our watercolor paper and fold the two tabs of the sheet inward. All right, now we're gonna set this aside. We're going to grab a clean tray and place it on our mess mat. Done. And we're going to scoop any combination of mixtures onto the tray. You choose the colors. We just want to make sure that they overlap. We won't put all of them together on one spot, but we can do like red and blue in the same area, and we can do some yellow and blue in the same area. I'm gonna do red and blue in one area, okay? Now that we have our tray prepped, we're going to take our spray bottle and we're gonna spray our combo. Will you spray it all around?
Mm-hmm.
And we're gonna take our card and we're gonna hold the tissue paper, or we're gonna hold the water paper on the tabs and dip it into the tray and gently press. Can you take it out and show the camera? Ooh, look at that.
That's pretty.
And we're gonna take our tissue paper and we're going to lay it over the tissue paper and let it dry. We can make another one. Look at this one.
Whoa.
We're gonna let these dry.
Oh, so when we do our next one, we let those dry on the side?
Okay, we're gonna let our cards dry, and once they're finished, we will come back and put them in their card holders.
Now that our water papers are dry, we're gonna make our cards.
We have a bunch of different stencils to choose from. Which one do you wanna use, Ainsley?
I wanna use this one.
Okay, that's one, and you pick one more.
You pick.
Okay. I will choose the hearts. Okay, maybe it just sits like that. All right, and now we have our card.
Whoa, that's actually pretty. I didn't expect it to be pretty.
Look at mine. Let's move on to the next experiment. What do you say?
Let's do it.
Okay, let's get started with our last experiment. We're going to choose a color and add two scoops into the flask. We want to put it into the flask. Two scoops. And now they want us to unscrew the spray bottle and pour water into the flask until you see a reaction. What do you think is gonna happen? Ooh, it's bubbling over. Maybe we can add some more. Look at that.
Do we have another thing that we can do?
Yeah,
like another craft thing to do?
Ooh, okay, I'm gonna go rinse this out. We'll try a new color. Let's pour water into the flask first and then add mixture and see if it gives us a different reaction. I'm gonna add some red and see what happens. Okay, maybe we'll add some yellow to the flask and see if we can get any sort of reaction. Is it blowing, is it going orange? Are we ready? This is gonna be a big reaction.
Pour the whole blue, I dare you. And the whole red.
Well, no, because we need a little bit of room to put the water in. Okay, let's see what happens.
Whoa! That's awesome!
Look at that! So what did we learn today? We learned that citric acid and baking soda can cause a chemical reaction.
This has been so fun. I really like all these Kiwico boxes that I've been doing. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.